Olá pessoal, estamos agora direto do Hotel Westin aqui de Milão, onde vai começar o evento de MBA que nós viemos cobrir aqui.
Se non voti ti fai del male.
Nessa versão italiana da feira foram inscritos mais de 80 candidatos que já foram pré-selecionados e estão vindo hoje fazer suas entrevistas. E essa configuração é a mesma que está sendo levada para o Brasil agora em março. O curso de MBA da Universidade de Manchester, uma das maiores, mais prestigiadas universidades do Reino Unido. Estamos aqui com a senhora Helen, que vai falar um pouquinho para a gente das expectativas da instituição dela para o evento no mercado brasileiro.
Well, in Manchester, actually, we have a very strong presence in Latin America as a whole. So with our full-time MBA program, actually now 20% of our class are from Latin America. So we always have some excellent Brazilian candidates on the MBA, but also candidates from throughout Latin America region. So for us, it is a very important region. We really enjoy having the students coming from this region. They do very well on the program. They're getting very good positions after the program, both outside of Latin America and also those that are coming back to the region. We have two MBA programs. We have the full-time MBA program, where we're taking about 120 students, and they're coming from between 35 to 40 different countries. So that program is where we have 20% of the class coming from Latin America, and typically 3 to 5 students coming from Brazil in that class. And then we also have the global MBA program, which is a part-time program, and for that program we have 6 centers around the world.
Okay.
And one of those is actually in Brazil.
They can do part of the program there in São Paulo and then walk around. How does it work?
How that works is that the program takes 3 years, and they study part-time, but it's a blended learning program, so they study partly by themselves, but then they attend workshops at our centres for each course that they take. Each workshop is 20 hours. So they need to attend those workshops twice per year, so about one week, twice per year. So then all of the students come together from the different locations and meet together to talk about what they've been studying.
Pessoal, mais uma universidade de renome, estamos agora na Cambridge Business School. Vamos falar com o senhor Conrad Schwa, que é o diretor responsável pela parte de recrutamento e admissão.
Cambridge MBA is very much a global MBA, even though we're full-time residents in Cambridge, so we don't have any exchange or anything like that. We have students from all over the world, they've worked all over the world as well. And the emerging markets is actually something that we're very interested to build up. So far, about 40% of our students are from Asia.
Okay.
Yeah. About 20% from North America, another 20% from Western Europe. So Latin America and Brazil in particular is one area which I personally am very interested to build up. We have about 150 to 160 students every year.
Okay.
They have at least 3 years of work experience.
3 years, okay.
Yes, at least 3 years. They've done well in GMAT, academics, and done well in their work experience as well. They come from all different kinds of sectors, so finance, consulting, industry, and that's why I think for the Brazilian market, we'd be very interested, because Brazil is obviously growing in all of these areas, and they're very interesting problems, interesting, but also interesting solutions that are emerging from Brazil, which I think our students would benefit greatly if they could interact with Brazilian students. On the other hand, Brazilian students, I think, would learn a lot from interacting with students from around the world in Cambridge, because a lot of Brazilian companies, of course, are globalizing.
Yeah, sure, you know? Sure.
And so I think that would be a very good good mix for both Brazilian students and our students. We've had very good employment outcomes.
Okay.
So in the most recent class, we had 97% of our students who were looking for jobs. They accepted a job offer within 3 months.
Wow.
And most of them, I would say about 40% stayed in the UK, about one-third went to Asia, and then the rest was spread out. I personally am very hopeful that we get more Brazilian students who actually go back to Brazil, because I think the opportunities there are tremendous, and I think Brazil also needs a lot of talent. We've not had that many Brazilian students before, and most of them have actually stayed on to work, let's say, in Europe or in the UK. But it's my hope that, you know, Cambridge could play a part in Brazil's development if some of the Brazilian students who come to Cambridge get the benefits of that global MBA education and then go back and contribute to that development.
Ok, pessoal, estamos mais em mais uma grande instituição agora da Espanha e encontramos um curso chamado Global Executivo, Executivo Global. Estamos aqui com a senhora Vani, que vai explicar para a gente um pouquinho mais desse curso, e eles têm também já uma representação em São Paulo. Parte do curso pode ser feita em São Paulo.
We're looking for people who have had a standout career evolution. They've been working for about over at least 10 years, and they've had some, you know, they've been working for companies that usually span different continents, different countries. They have a real open mind. They want to learn. They want to study business in a very global context. So they want to be with people from very diverse backgrounds, very different functions, sectors, industries. That's what we do.
Pessoal, então é isso. Deu para sentir um pouquinho do evento e principalmente a expectativa do pessoal em relação aos eventos do Brasil. As universidades estão todas confirmando presença. Acho que vale a pena dar um pulo lá, marcar sua entrevista e ver o que o mundo hoje está oferecendo em relação aos novos MBAs.
Siete lastricar.